But that lady, that's Liz Chalmers, and she owns a birthing centre in America. So this is part of her, you know, kind of antenatal classes for women. But actually, you, Keli, went, oh, no, actually, time to think about it, that might have been quite a useful tool.
Just from the perspective of visualising the what's happening inside and how you have to sort of, you know, bear down. You know what I mean? It would have helped me visualise it, I think, and then, I mean... Yeah, my birthing story was quite complicated.
Very complicated. Yeah, because you've got lovely twin boys.
I have, yeah.
Who are
Leo
5.
And Milo, yeah.
Yeah, there they look at them. So
look
beautiful.
At them.
But not identical twins, which
They're
is where
identical.
The complications happened.
Yeah, so they went in with non-identical twins, you have, they're in separate sacs. So twin one decides when they want to be born. But twin two may not want to be born then, on that day, at that time. So what happened with me was that I gave birth to Theo in a natural way. It was lovely, pushed down, all nice and chilled, like the movies. And then I was ready, yeah, one bead of sweat. And then I felt ready to give birth to Milo, but he just, you know, he didn't want to come out. So then it was an emergency C-section scenario.
So that's very terrifying, isn't it? Suddenly, yeah. Like you said, you'd been all calm and it was relatively okay.
Yeah.
And then
suddenly the room
panic.
Was busy. And with twins, each child has their own team of people. So the room was just so busy with staff. It was like a party. There was a laser show going on outside. Well, it was the night that they were launching the shard. I had windows all around
like,
my
yeah,
birthing suite,
the
and there was a laser show. Yeah, there was a laser show going on outside. So yeah, it was like a party. 30 odd people in the room. It was.
But you're saying, is it because when one is born, the birthing canal is open, so that there's a risk of infection?
Yes,
they've got to get a second baby.
Exactly
out.
Right. So there can't be too much time before the second twin comes
and
out.
Is it quite unusual to have a natural birth and a cesarean at the same kind in the same sort of birth?
Yeah, very unusual. Doesn't happen very often, but I'd been reassured many times in all my appointments that it wouldn't happen to me because I was young and I was healthy and all of this stuff and very experienced obstetrician. But unfortunately for me, I went into labour naturally, and when I just went into labour, it wasn't his shift.
Oh. You must be feel very torn because you've given birth to, was it Theo
one
first?
I know, I was just thinking
yeah,
that.
Yeah, sorry. But one's there.
Yeah.
Kind of, and then suddenly all this drama
yeah,
goes
and because I remember saying to my husband after I'd given birth to Theo, I was like, where is he? Where is he? And he said, he's on your chest. And I looked down and he was on my chest and then they whipped him away and it was just an emergency scenario from then on and I didn't get to look his face or hold him and I could just hear him crying in the background while they were preparing me for surgery. He was crying obviously the whole way through the
Milo's
birth.
So why do you think a balloon and a ping pong ball would have helped?